Baby, lo che dice, ero triste, la sua triste, no te dico, ma che ero tu, io, che ero tu, oh, oh.
Baby, lo che dice, ero triste, no mi la sua no te fije, no, ma che ero tu, io.
Just the general, east side up, LBC, y'all know how I go down on the west coast, yeah, on the B-side show, motherfucker, gangster shit. What's up, this the general, east.
We back in here, man.
DJ Lumen.
Lumen on the ones and twos, man. You know we're funky every Monday night, man. All up in your grill. Hey, check it out. We got our homeboy in the building, man. I'm gonna let him introduce himself, but this dude's been doing a lot for hip-hop, man. So salute, man. Oh, wait. Let me make sure we're on here. I just saw a wrong. There we go.
Saw red light.
I saw a red light. Go ahead, Droops.
Yo, check it out. I go by Droops of Out the House Productions, holding it down. A lot of you might have heard of me from the Observatory. Back in the days, Malone's. If you go way back, then you'll
DJ
think La Pachanga.
DJ Droops.
Back in the DJ Droops days. Yeah. It's been a minute. It's been a minute since I've been DJing. But, yeah, I had to hang up the turntables after a few years once the promoting started taking over, you know?
But for greater things, though. For greater things.
Yeah, definitely. You know, back then, Orange County would never really had, like, a full-on hip-hop scene. So I really had a choice to make. Do I want to keep rapping and DJing and producing? Or do I just, like, commit towards the hip-hop shows, which, like I said, Orange County never really had a consistency. It had a scene, don't get me wrong. It had a hip-hop scene. There's a lot of dope artists out there, too. But I definitely just wanted to provide that platform. So that's how I started doing Open Mic Night.
And from Open Mic Night to what it is now, and we'll go back to that, but yeah. The Observatory, OC, and all the other shows that you have your hand in, Droops, but it's almost like... And this is what I feel sometimes with this show here. It's almost a responsibility now. People are waiting for the shows that you're going to put out next, yeah. Bro. Because you got some dope shows you guys are putting together.
Ah, definitely. You know, I honestly, lately, I feel like my phone number is like an 800 hotline. For real. No bullshit, dog. Like, I wake up every day to, like, another artist, whether it's someone that I work with or new artists, like, oh, yo, what's the next show? Yo, what's the next show? Like, I'm just like, because they're just waiting for the next show, you know, to get on or whatnot. And the fact that we bring different styles of hip-hop shows now that I'm with the Observatory, we have a little bit of for everybody. So just like artists, underground artists, West Coast gangster rap, trap artists, you know, all of the above, you know, we have a little something for everybody. And
even
so,
singers and everything.
Lately we've been doing a lot more R&B shows, actually, as a matter of fact. So I've been getting R&B cats hitting me up like, yo, what's up? But lately I really had to be like, yo, I don't book on weekends no more. Straight out, unless I'm doing a show, that's the only time I'm working. But I'm usually always working. But lately I've been like, yo, on the weekends.
I like how you know, sometimes you have to be real straightforward with people because they don't get it when you beat around the bush.
Nah.
But I like when you put on your posts, there's no guest list, there's no tickets left, do not hit me up, do not, you know, but they still don't get it, and I bet you still get a
gang
of
money. Like, for real, like, I'll post up a flyer that says sold out, like you said, no tickets, no guest list, all that, and they're like, hey, we've seen that it's sold out online, but do you still have tickets? And I'm like, fuck, I just don't answer those
and
texts no more. Like, for real.
It says, do not hit me up. And they'll say, hey, Droops, what's up, homeboy? Hey, oh, man, I don't, trust me, I don't
crazy,
get it
dog.
Either.
Crazy.
Hey, but another big event, too, this Saturday, hip hop's in full effect, man. We got the No Label Fest in San Bernardino, and then in the OC. Go ahead and let them know what you got this Saturday.
We have our once a year, our fifth year annual Back to Basics event. Headlining, we got my boys Living Legends gonna be in the building. We got Immortal Technique gonna be rocking the mic. The Visionary Crew, big ups to Tumex. I just seen you at B-Real TV.
That's right.
Homie fucking killed it and shit.
He did something live, right?
Yeah, he did some live shit. Yeah, it's a new track, fresh. He just did it yesterday and he did that shit live. We also got we got like Necro rocking the show. We got Evidence of Dilated Peoples. We got Sick Jacking of Psycho Realm. I'm gonna announce it now. We were supposed to wait till tomorrow, but people already started leaking it out here and there. We got the homies, the Alcoholics, gonna be rocking the show too. And I'll let it be known too. We got a Kill of Jurassic 5 gonna be rocking the mic. And maybe one more special guest that I won't announce until you see the flyer. So
hey, see, yeah. You know, sometimes you got to do it like yeah. that, man. But it stays consistent, though, man.
It's yeah, yeah. You know, we do that festival like once every year, and I always tell everybody it's one of those shows that's very special to me. Come from the underground hip hop background. You know, my heart's always been there since I was a teenager. Obviously, started off with like West Coast gangster rap, like I said, Eazy-E, Tupac, you know, all them, but. Once I heard underground shit, like I heard Wu-Tang and I heard like Psychorom, Jedi Mind Tricks and shit like that, I was like, damn, I got to dig deeper. I need to find what else is out there.
Took
and shit,
it to
you
a
know?
Whole nother level, right?
Yeah, so like I said, the fifth year annual, we skipped the year last year because of our crazy ass schedule of shows that we do at the Observatory. We had to make this year a little bit more special by adding all the elements this year. Previous years we had some of the elements, but we finally hit up the B-Boys to do the break dancing. We got the graffiti artist going to be doing the thing. And then we got the DJ Scratch Battle. It's going to be hosted by Mark Love, DJ Mark Love.
What up, Mark Love, Zulu yeah, yeah. Tribe Radio, man. Be Real TV. Yeah. Those are the homies
yeah,
over
yeah.
there.
And of course, you know, the MC is going to be rocking the mic, of course, too. So, yeah, it's going to be special. I encourage everybody to come out. If you're in the Orange County area, come check it out. It's going to be one of those memorable shows. Also, if you're in San Diego, we're doing a second day that day after. So if you miss out on Saturday, you can come through to San Diego.
Observatory in San Diego.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, Observatory right. North Park.
And then the other thing is there's one coming up. What is it? August. The LBC.
Oh, the LBC. Summertime in LBC
there you
show.
Go. That one, man. I have people hitting me up, like my tias and all these people. No, but girls, I have random people going, hey, man, you're going to go to that show? And I go, from what I know, it's already sold out.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
I'm trying to tell them, leave me alone already.
It's crazy, dog, because a lot of people were doubting that lineup when it was presented to me like about a month or two before. And I was like, bro, like this lineup's going to fucking kill and shit. Like, let's do it. And then the talent buyer's like, yo, we're getting a lot of bad feedback from the higher-ups. They're saying, like, it's not going to sell right. I'm like, bro, trust me, it's going to kill. And sure enough, we put it online. The first two tiers sold out within an hour.
That's what I was saying, yeah.
And then the show sold out completely, like, in about, like, 3 weeks after yeah. announcement. So, yeah, you know, 50 Cent with G-Unit, Wu-Tang Clan, YG... we took it back. Probably that's why your theos are asking about Brenton Wood and
yeah,
the Mary
no,
Jane
that,
girls.
There was yeah.
You know, we also have like some underground dope shit, Hieroglyphics, Souls of Mischief. Man, the list keeps going. I can't remember everything off the top. We got Lady Rage gonna be in the building. There's a lot of people. That show is gonna be definitely memorable. It was labeled as the 10-year anniversary. I gotta put this shit live on every radio show or every media outlet. It's not my 10-year anniversary show. It's where we're celebrating our 10-year anniversary of Out the House Productions.
Okay.
Honestly, I consider our real 10-year anniversary Back to Basics.
Okay.
Because that's something that I created, you know,
There it is there. And you
there it is, on the air. So all the rappers and headliners that were mad at me for not putting you on, I'm not the organizer behind that. I just gave some of the suggestions, and that was it.
Yeah, stop getting mad at him when he don't answer his phone.
Hey,
let's talk about being successful. You know, there's a lot of people that want to follow, you know, in your footsteps. A lot of people that want to throw shows and be successful. What does it take to be successful?
Well, honestly, every time I go to, like, interviews and shit like that, I always tell everybody it's just consistency. Yeah. Like, really doing your thing, and it's not giving up, like... Like, I've literally been doing shows for the last 10 years every month. I haven't stopped. If anything, the number of shows has gone up from two shows a month to, like, the following year, like, five shows a month to, like, the following year after that, 10 shows a month to the 15. I'm at the point where I'm doing about 20, 30 shows a month right now. And it's just because of the consistency of just staying out there, always being in their face, because... The moment you step away for like a month or two, especially if you stop back for like a year, someone else comes in.
Someone's ready, bro.
Someone's ready to just go in and hungry. You know, hey, that's hungry as you,
and, so. And that's why, sorry you guys, but you're not taking the B-side spot. We're here every fucking Monday.
For real.
We're here every fucking Monday, man. You know that's, no, yeah. But real shit though. No, yeah. That's why we get dope artists though. Like you said it, it's real talk. That's why we get dope artists here, bro, is because we're consistent though.
Yeah,
for real.
OGHuskyRadio.net, OG Husky Radio. You guys have been around with us since day one, since the Malone's days. When we're doing like, you know, 200-300 capacity spots to 500 to now 1,000 and plus. So,
yeah,
you know, definitely. I appreciate you guys for holding it down for that long, because the hip hop scene needs us all.
That's right. You know. Hey, and look, and here's one more thing I want before we sign out here with Droops. We got Self Provoked coming up next. I wanted to say, I just saw you at Dose 6 Candlelight Vigil.
Yeah.
Vigil, and the thing is these are some of the artists that, like you was mentioning earlier, you get cats that you take a chance on and you put them on to open up for. These dudes were consistent and they were coming up. So it was a sad thing, man. Carnage and the whole crew still doing their thing, but it was sad to see the homie, because they were really getting that momentum going with the, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like they were supposed to rock back to basics, and that's why we're dedicating that show, that festival to them, because I literally met him like 3 days before he went on his camping trip, dog. He was stoked about the show. The whole crew was with it. You know, they've never came sideways or nothing, dog. They've always been humble cats, and, you know, he was supposed to be on that stage, so we're definitely going to dedicate that to him. You know, big ups to Dosik, you know, where you rest in peace, you know, and the whole Rebellion Warfare crew. You know, we're doing this one for you guys, too, and shit, so...
That's right, man. Make sure you guys tune in. You guys follow him, Out the House Productions, man. You guys see shows going down every week. For sure.
And it's Out the House, D-A, not T-H-E.
Yeah.
Out the House. Follow me on Instagram, Facebook. It's all the same, Out the House. So this is how we do it.
And when he puts, he's not answering, he's really not answering. You can't read properly.
Oh yeah. You know what the new thing is? It's text only.
All right.
Text only. Eventually, I'll go back through those texts. But if you just keep calling and I don't have your number saved, I don't answer calls I don't recognize. So it's just text.
Hey, every once in a while, you know, he has a personal life. You know, give him a break. Hey, but Out the House Productions, man, in the building, man. Troops, thank you for always being down with the B-side as well, man. And, you know, you see us on the flyers and stuff like that. And, again, it's because consistency, and we're about this hip-hop shit. So salute to you as well. We'll be right back after this, man. We got Self Provoked in the building. B-side.
Out the House Shots. Big ups.